Hi, Seth Shostak here at the SETI Institute. Kind of wonder why you're watching me when you could be doing something useful for yourself, like learning Polish. But let me tell you about this week's Big Picture Science show. Now, you've all heard of superbugs, and I know many of you think that that's a, you know, an expensive model of a VW Beetle, but that's not what we're talking about. We're talking about bacteria that have evolved to have a resistance to all the usual antibiotics. So we talked to a couple that was traveling in Egypt when suddenly the guy got sick, right? Really sick. They had to fly him to Germany. He had developed a bug that the antibiotics weren't treating. It was a closely run thing. And then they found a cure, or at least a treatment, that dates back like 100 years, even before antibiotics, and that's called phage therapy. Phage therapy, right? Phage, I mean, you're thinking, okay, set phages on stun. No, not that kind of phage. Phage, P-H-A-G-E. These are little things that look like, I don't know, something made out of a mechano set, right, that attack bacteria. And we've known that for a long time. But because antibiotics were so successful in the West, we didn't do much phage research. Well, that may be coming back, and we talk about that. And one last thing that we do in the show that you might find fun, Molly goes to Tennessee to visit a body farm. What's a body farm? You think they're growing bodies? Is this, you know, like a zombie nursery or something like? No, what it is a place where they take bodies, donated bodies, dead ones, they put them out in the fields in the hot sun, right? And they just look at how they rot. Sounds a little perverse, right? But that allows them to determine the parameters that would tell police departments, hey, when was this crime committed? It's actually very useful from a forensic point of view, even if a bit maggoty and grubby and kind of disgusting overall. Tune in this week's Big Picture Science.